couple years later, I think, after the articulation index came out, something called the speech interference level came out. It's called SIL. There's also preferred speech interference level, which just has to do with which octave bands are chosen to calculate this. It's basically a arithmetic mean of the octave bands that are most important to understanding human speech, and it's just finding the mean of those octave bands. The ones that people are typically concerned about are from 500 to 4 kilohertz. One unique thing about SIL and PSIL that's different from AI, the articulation index, is that the distance is actually accounted for in how well you will be able to hear somebody. So here's the equations. For PSIL, what they're doing is they're taking the dB value at the 500 hertz octave, the dB value at the 1000 hertz octave, and the dB value at the 2000 hertz octave, divided by 3. SIL3 is 1000, 2000, and 4000, and then ANSI is basically both of these combined. Quick example, it's very easy to calculate. If I had 3 octave bands, 500, 1000, and 2000, I would just find the dB values at those, add them together, and divide by 3. So the PSIL for this exact example would be about 66 dB. The nice thing about this standard is it gives you an idea of what that'll look like compared to distance. So if I have that 60 dB and I am, let's say, 2 feet away from somebody who's talking to me, I'm the listener and I'm 2 feet away from the speaker, I should absolutely be able to hear no problems with normal, adequate voice. If I'm 16 feet away, they'll probably have to yell a little bit. If I'm like 20 feet away, they're probably going to be shouting at me. I mean, that seems to make sense with the way that I've experienced sound in my life. If you are in a very noisy environment, so if you're in like a really loud factory floor that's like in the 90 dB range, even if you're 1 foot apart, you're going to have a really hard time understanding each other if you find out where you are in this graph. And obviously, the further apart you are, the way more difficult it gets. Quick example, I have a background level that's 85 dB. I have a friend who's only 1 foot apart. I'm in the expected voice level of communicating. I should have no problems. If I have that same sound level and I'm 8 feet apart, I am in the maximum vocal effort and I will probably be screaming, and there will probably be a lot of information that's lost between those. So that's the main difference. And these graphs, once again, were made around the same time that the standards were coming out. So it tells you how much background noise will interfere with human speech based on not only the levels, but also the distance. So PSIL, once again, is calculated using these three bands, SILs, these three bands, and ANSIs, all four. If you want to do this in test lab, it's super easy. All you need to do is right-click on your data, go to calculated content, add these guys in, and then you should be good to go. It will give you your PSIL or SIL or whatever you choose, these three, for your data. So once again, there's a couple different variants, and a quick reminder that no voices are actually ever measured. You're measuring the sound in the room and then finding out if one would be able to communicate effectively or not.